If you need any Xbox or PlayStation codes or anything gaming related, check the referral links down in the description. They'll take you to g2a.com. They already have a discount on most of their goods already, and with the code CHEZ at checkout, you can get yourself an extra 3% off as well. Hey guys, how's it going? Chez back again, and welcome to episode number 20 of My Player here on FIFA 15. The first game today, as we discussed yesterday, is the second leg in the area final of the Johnson's Paint Trophy. We're up 1-0 from the first leg, and if we can get a victory or even a draw in this one, just avoid defeat, we'll go through to the final at Wembley for later on in the season. We're now out of the January transfer window. No offers came in for us. We weren't actively looking for a move away. We'll do that at the end of the season. Currently top of the table with Cambridge here in our opening season, My Player, and it seems fitting to help them gain promotion and perhaps even win a trophy in the Johnson's Paint if we can for our first year. We've also got a game away against Bury as the second game of the episode, so hopefully we can do well. If you enjoy the video, then feel free to hit that like button. Of course, subscribe if you haven't already as well, to make sure you don't miss out on any videos on this channel, whether it's this series, the Atletico Madrid series, which was up on the channel last night and will be again, of course, tonight as well, or the Chelsea career mode, which goes up during the week. So check this channel page for anything you may have missed. There's also a schedule in the description of every video and on the About tab of the channel page to let you know exactly what and when I upload, so that you make sure you don't miss a single video. But let's jump into this game against Bristol then. We had a very tough game in the opening leg, went down to 10 men early on as well. We're able to come away with a sneaky last minute winner thanks to a free kick from myself. Maybe we can have the impact on today's game as well. Might make a run down the line here for Greg Taylor to find me if he can. And he's done well. We'll try the quick turn inside the defender. It's worked. We will pass off to Luke Chadwick, who'll have the shot deflected. A great save from Frankie Fielding. Gives Cambridge a corner in the 7th minute. That was a decent effort. Nice breakaway from the team there. Pleased to be able to be involved in a move like that. Hopefully that is a sign of good things to come for the rest of this game. Although the corner is straight at the goalkeeper. That is pretty disappointing after the way that initial move went. Come down the line on the other side now. Liam Hughes playing over the top. We brought it down well. There is a man in the middle, so I'll stand it up. We may find him. Luke Chadwick's there off the post. Frankie Fielding can do nothing about that one. J. Emmanuel Thomas up to Kieran Agard. Beats the man, but gets tackled by the second. We will eventually get that away. I'll call for it here, and we'll try a quick, sharpish counter-attack if we can. Luke Chadwick into Mitch Austin. I'll call for a through ball. It's not going to come. Here's Robbie Simpson, though. Will find me this time. We'll lay it off to Liam Hughes, who's going to find Diallo in the box. Diallo, you've got to hit the target, mate. There's no excuse for smashing that one wide from that sort of range. That could have given us a perfect, perfect 2-0 lead in the tie overall. Unfortunately, we haven't been able to take it. Oh, it wasn't the best. In fact, it may have been a brilliant ball. Oh, crunching tackle from Cunningham. Almost half time here. Bristol City trying to catch us on the counter attack. No real clear cut opportunities apart from the one that Diallo had at the half hour mark or so. But it's a 0-0 draw so far. But of course, we are still 1-0 up on aggregate. So everything going according to plan so far. Elliot up to Emmanuel Thomas. Chance at the beginning of the second half, perhaps. Little might get a cross in. In fact, he's just fed it into Emmanuel Thomas, who gets past one man and the second man in the box beautifully. Out to Wade Elliott. Great block by Michael Nelson. That was absolutely vital. We needed to get a block on that shot, because if Bristol score, you get the feeling they'll get the momentum and go ahead and score more. A clean sheet could be absolutely vital in getting ourselves through to the national final of the Johnson's Paint Trophy at Wembley. Here's J. Emmanuel Thomas. Oh, nice little back heel back to Wade Elliott. Ball forward, Kieran Agard's in. Question of a penalty and given. Chris Dunn takes out Kieran Agard as he receives the ball into feet. What's going to happen to the goalkeeper? Is he going to get sent, or is he only going to get a yellow? Because that clearly was a goal-scoring opportunity. I'm not sure. Well, A, that isn't a penalty because he's clearly palmed the ball away. And B, I'm not sure what card the referee gave him, if one at all. He may not have given... Well, it's definitely not a red because he still stood there. Don't think he's been booked at all, Chris Dunn. This is the chance then for Bristol City to get themselves level on aggregate. Can they do it? It's Wade Elliott with the penalty. Played the ball through to Kieran Agard and he rifles it straight down the middle of the net. It's Bristol City 1, Cambridge 0 on the night. 1-1 on aggregate. Looks like we might be going to extra time, although there are still 25 minutes to decide the rest of this tie. Kieran Agard's run straight into Mitch Austin there. We've got perhaps a decent chance at a counter-attack here if Ryan Donaldson can find a decent pass. He's found Robbie Simpson linking up really well with Robbie Simpson. It changed me to a left striker, so I'm going to have some support up top with me for the remainder of this game. The next goal will probably decide who goes through and who goes out. I only think there's going to be one more goal in this if a goal is to come. The question is, which way will it go? Emmanuel Thomas through to Carly Osborne, the centre-back pushing forward. Clearly Bristol City wanting to press the issue. Cunningham with a great whip in. Emmanuel Thomas is underneath it and it's hit the side netting. That was a good opportunity for them to make it 2-0 and 2-1 retrospectively with the aggregate score. Only a few inches wide of that near post. Smith to Agard. Agard, great ball over the top. Aaron Wilbraham's underneath it. I can't believe it. They've made it 2-0 on the night, 2-1 on aggregate with just 2 minutes left. All the twos here, and it looks like we're going to be coming up short when it comes to getting through to the final at Wembley with the Johnson's Paint Trophy. Oh, absolute heartbreak. Keeper in no man's land, gave away a penalty and then makes a mistake. Both goals seemingly Chris Dunn's fault here. It looks like we're going to be going out of the competition. There goes the final whistle. It's too little, too late for us. A second goal for Bristol City, 2 minutes from time, is going to see them progress through to the area final. Not the area final, this was the area final. Progress through to the national final. The chance to win a trophy at Wembley goes to Bristol City. We've battled so hard throughout this competition, beating teams from higher divisions. Unfortunately, though, Bristol City was one hurdle too many. Oh, really, really disappointed with that. We had a good game, personally. It was very, very close, as you can see. They just took their chances and we didn't. Oh, Bristol City 2, Cambridge 0 on the night, 2-1 on aggregate. We're going to have to try and pick ourselves up for this Bury game. Here's Luke Chadwick into Whittle. I'll call for it from Sam Whittle. See the run coming here from the mound from the middle. Tom Champion with the shot driven low. Jalal makes a decent save there. This is, of course, first versus third in the league. We're top, Bury a third. It's an extremely important game that comes straight after an extremely important game in the Cup. We've lost the first one. We cannot afford to lose the second, because if, you know, the morale in the camp drops from two defeats in two big games, it could affect the rest of our season. Corner for Bury, 15 minutes in. Hussey's going to be the man to whip it in. They've got a few men in the box, not too many, but they almost find the head of a teammate, and Jones is going to break into the box from the corner, have the shot. A wonderful block from Josh Coulson. Don't know whether that shot was on target or not, but it needed some sort of blocking, and Josh Coulson was the man to do that. They'll try again from the corner. Hopefully keeper will be a little bit more composed this time around. It looks like we're playing Will Norris in goal this time as opposed to Chris Dunn. He's been dropped after the two mistakes in the Bristol game. That won't do his morale a lot of good. We mentioned earlier on about trying to keep morale high. It's not really the best way to go about it from the manager, but still, Bury with a third corner in quick succession. This time they do get a shot on target, but Norris is down well to keep it out. Really working too far, because Bury have got so many men back, he can't really keep it out, but that cross has come in. Hussey with a great clearance, he's injured himself, I think, in actually getting that away. Luke Chadwick fires it in, he has gone down and stayed down, Hussey. That was a really... what a leap! He jumps about 4 foot in the air there. Absolute Cristiano Ronaldo stuff. We're going to get the ball back, but he's unfortunately going to have to go off injured, I think, Hussey. That was a hell of a jump. Widdowson's come on in his place. Chadwick and Champion linking up well here. I'll call for it from Tom Champion. Might try and take it around the man. We've got a chance on our left foot. We'll have the shot. It's off target. I was about to say it's on target and it's into the net. It wasn't quite. Decent angle for it. Just couldn't quite bend it into that far post. Not a bad shot though with our weak foot. Turns into a two who quickly fired up to Ryan Lowe. Tries to stand it up in the box. I'll call for it. Chance for counter-attack if the half-time whistle doesn't go, which it hasn't so far. We'll call for the through ball from Luke Chadwick. He's found me. I see the runner, but the question is, has he got the pace to get past the man? He doesn't, but we do have the pace to get past that particular man. Ryan Donaldson might find me now. The question is, can I get a turn in? I can't. Donaldson with a hit. It's gone well wide, and that's probably the end of the first half, and indeed it is. So again, 0-0 at the break, hoping that this time we'll be on the score sheet in the second half and not the opposition. Widdowson down the left-hand side. A lot of space for cross. Does eventually get it in on his clearly more favoured right foot. We should get this away. Greg Taylor We'll find Liam Hughes trying to drift this way to try and give an option should we need it to counter-attack, but that is a great ball. And I'll call for a through ball from Greg Taylor, and we're in behind here. Just need a decent first touch. I'll come inside the defender. Hasn't quite worked. We've lost it, but Mills has dropped as far as me, and we've made it 1-0. They make a horrific error trying to get inside the box. Didn't quite work, but then they make just as big a defensive mistake as we made an offensive mistake, and we profit from it eventually. Terrible turn inside from me, but a mix-up in defence means it drops kindly at my feet, and we slot it into the back of the net. Cambridge 1, Bury 0. Tuhu out to Soares, back into a Tuhu, but Diallo's done well to cut that out. This game is picking up tempo-wise. Bury with another man down. We'll call for the through ball from Hughes again. Now this time, in fact, I don't even need to cut inside the man because he's done it for me. And a finesse shot. Wow. We've got the finesse shot trait on and we can't finish a chance like that. I just thought I'd put a tiny little bit of power on it, try and slot it past him. Our finishing stat isn't quite high enough yet because that was a great opportunity. I looked a little bit like, my guy looked a little bit like Robin Williams there. Anyway, they've had another man injured, but we stay at 1-0 with 15 minutes to go. Not long left to go now with Bury on the attack. Diallo chooses not to go in for the second total there. And Tuck comes away with it. Here's Ryan Lowe on the edge of the box. Stands it up. Bury looking for an equaliser. Paul flicks it on, but Greg Taylor should get it away. I'll call for the ball. And if I can flick this on, which we have done, we might have the chance for a second goal. Ryan Donaldson trying to race away. I'm going to give him some support. He is going to use me. Can we finish the game off? Oh, Jalal comes out well and smothers. And they hook the ball clear. Bury aren't going to get themselves any from the game. I was going to say Bury still have a chance, but they don't. The goalkeeper did well to keep them in it. They're right in the death, but it wasn't enough. Cambridge 1, Bury 0 is the final score. We do get the goal, although could quite possibly have had a hat-trick from that game. Disappointed with some of the finishing, but the one shot that we had on target, the one goal that we got, was enough to get all 3 points. How did Oxford get on? That's first versus third. We won. Oxford drew, so our lead at the top of the table should have extended. We will check the league table. It has. It's extended to 3 points. Only 15 games left to go now in the League 2 season. We are two-thirds of the way through this first year, and we're looking sitting pretty at the top of the table. Player stats, let's have a quick look. So we are still leading goal scorer in the League 2 with 17. Ryan Lowe is second with 12. Three players on 12 there. And assist-wise, we won't be anywhere near the top of that because we don't have barely any assists. We have one, I think, so far this season in the league. Indeed, we do. One assist in the league. We've got 17 goals so far this year, and they only want 19 for the target. So that's pretty much guaranteed that we're going to get at least that. I do need another 5 assists, though, so somewhere I need to improve on, and my match rating and goal conversion rate. Although, the way I played in that last game, probably could have improved that if I'd have taken those 2 extra shots. And it would have meant that we'd matched the target for goals as well if we had got a hat-trick. Nevertheless, 71 rated, coming towards the 60-75%, the three-quarter mark perhaps, in this first season. Growing nicely as a professional, still scoring goals, need to pick up a few assists, but the team are doing well, just disappointed to have been knocked out in the Johnson's Paint Trophy at the second-to-last hurdle. But we'll be back on Tuesday for more My Player. Of course, there'll be Atletico Madrid career mode tonight, Chelsea tomorrow, as well as more Atleti. 2 videos every single day on this channel, but Tuesday's episode of My Player will have York and Wickham. But that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Check the channel page for anything you may have missed. Drop the video a like, subscribe if you haven't. Check your sub boxes tonight for another Atleti episode, and I'll see you next time.